He is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Well, much has happened in the last few days. Just last Friday night, Governor Holcomb extended our, as he calls it, hunker down, our stay at home into May. And yet we know that he is indeed risen for you and me. There's no change in that. Staying at home, going to work, old normal, new normal, whatever it is, Christ is there for you and me. Let's join together in our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Those words help to demonstrate to you and me and to reinforce to you and me that it is God's will. It is his kingdom. And what we've been blessed with came from him, and we're to manage it for him. It's tough right now, we know. For all of us, hunkering down is not easy. And yet, look at what's happening in the world around us. Let's take a look at some of those things. In our scripture today, from 1 Peter, chapter 1, verses 22 through 25, these were the words. Having purified your souls by obedience to the truth, for a sincere brotherly love, love one another earnestly from a pure heart, since you have been born again, not of perishable seed, but of imperishable, through the living and loving word of God. For all flesh is like grass, and all of its glory like the flower of grass. The grass withers, and the flower falls, but the word of the Lord remains forever. And this word is the good news that was preached to you and me. Purifying our souls means we've accepted the Holy Spirit into our lives, that we believe in Jesus Christ and we lead that life that we're to lead, that life of prayer and service and discipline against the devil. And we're to love our brothers, our neighbors. For within that Christian life of service, it is our neighbors, it is our brothers and sisters. It's all across the world that we're to love and serve as we can, from that pure heart that Jesus talked about and that Peter is reminding us in these verses. And yes, we are perishable. Our bodies are perishable, but his word that works and lives through us never will perish. But the word of the Lord remains forever. Our flesh is like grass, which withers and fades away. And the flowers fall, and yet through those flowers, we see things we might not ever get to see. What are flowers to you? Colorful? Aromatic? Pleasing? Hard work? Appreciated? The hard work, I understand. 2 weeks ago, Marianne and I were out working in the gardens and pulling weeds. She much more than me, because I was raking leaves. But she was pulling the old leaves out, pulling out the growth that she needed to pull out, and really cleaned up this one small flower bed in our front yard. But the colors, as you can see in these examples here, the colors were lovely. And they told us that spring is coming, that God's kingdom on earth continues, and these are some of his blessings. But were there any flowers at the foot of the cross for Christ? Other than people, all of the pictures we see of Golgotha, the skull, where Christ was crucified, is of a rocky hill. There are no flowers. There are no living things. That's what God had to face. The faces he saw of his mother and the disciples clearly showed their love of him. as he experienced that horrible death. And then, like the flowers in Peter's examples, there they are. 2 weeks ago, that big wind came through and blew those flowers down. This was that small bed that we had cleaned up, that Mary Ann had done such a wonderful job of. And the flowers were just so vibrant, colorful. And the world around us, for those flowers, just like for you and me, a week later, just a little more than a week ago from today, we had a frost. And you can see they've wilted, but they're still alive. They're still colorful. They still show spring. 5 days ago, though, what happened? Yes, that Friday, my goodness, 2 inches of snow. Heavy, wet snow. Not enough to slow things down, but I guess, what are we doing? We're hunkering down. And so we could see what was happening to our flowers. And then last Saturday, 4 days ago, here they are coming back for you and me. Just as Christ will return again, so all of these things that God has given us to live with continue to be born again in their own way. I love those flowers. And you'll notice in this picture, even those small purple flowers have appeared at the lower part of the picture. Again, spring is here. New birth, growth, Christ out of the tomb into heaven. Extraordinary things. And we can take this even a step further. The National Geographic recently posted some videos that were sent to them by the space station. The European Space Station, circling the Earth repeatedly, has observed an extraordinary phenomenon. As the one scientist put it, at Christmas and New Year's, as you circle the Earth, you see changes in the amount of CO2 and the amount of particulates and emissions in the air. You slowly see some lessening of that negative impact on our atmosphere. But with COVID-19, it's dramatic. And if you go to the National Geographic site and take a look at this time-lapse video of our Earth, it's extraordinary how the Earth is healing itself at this time and what it has done for the world around us. Just extraordinary. Part of God's creation. Sin can be overcome. That life that the devil keeps to putting in front of us and around us can be overcome because the Word, and the Word is not just the spoken and written Word, but the Word that is God, is forever and overcomes death and the power of sin. So, such extraordinary things. Well, now it's time for us to join in prayer. And as I was out looking at prayers, I found this extraordinary prayer that not only reminds us of who we are, but of who we should be. It was titled, A Prayer to Combat the Coronavirus Pandemic. It was anonymous, posted. Let's pray together. Most merciful and triune God, we come to you in our weakness. We come to you in our fear. We come to you with trust. For you alone are our hope. We place before you the disease present in our world. We turn to you in time of need. Bring wisdom to doctors. Give understanding to scientists. Endow caregivers with compassion and generosity. Bring healing to those who are ill. Protect those who are most at risk. Give comfort to those who have lost a loved one. Welcome those who have died into your eternal home. Stabilize our communities. Unite us in our compassion. Remove all fear from our hearts. Fill us with confidence in your care. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Amen. And now, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.